farther. Some journeys take you farther from where you come from, but closer to where you belong. Gulsum Tech believes every woman has a story to narrate. Today, we are going to listen to the journey of defying all the fears and challenges, the journey of struggles, the journey of limitless commitments, the journey of passion and dedication from our speaker, Ekta Golcha. She is the founder and CEO of Delta Tech Private Limited, a software company based in Biratnagar, Nepal. Her journey of defying all the fears and challenges she encountered to get where she is now has become a source of encouragement and inspiration for many of us. Before starting the session, I'd like to address all the participants who are joining us through Facebook Live to please feel free to ask us any queries in the comment section. So we'd like to start our session with a speaker introduction. Over to you, ma'am.
Very good evening to everyone, and thank you for inviting me. This is Ekta Golcha. My company, Delta Tech, is a software development company based out of Biratnagar. Our main product, Delta Sales App, is a SaaS-based solution for field sales team. So we designed this in order to increase the productivity of sales teams. We also provide tech services like software, web and mobile app development. It's been 5 years since I started my company. Prior to this, I was working in India for 2 years as a data scientist. And regarding my education, I did my undergrad from Warwick University, UK, and my master's in mathematical and computational finance from Oxford University. And before that, I was studying in Biratnagar itself at DAV school till 10th, and 11th and 12th, I went to Pune to study.
Thank you, ma'am. So moving to our first question. So every child has a different nature. Kasiko nature sani dekhi ekdam matured ani huncha ani kasiko chai alikati pachi pachi time bhaye pachi responsibility aaye pachi mancheharu alikati body matured hune hununcha kasiko nature shy huncha bhanne kasiko nature ekdamai dherai bolna man parne type ko huncha. So what was your nature as a child? Do you see any radical difference in yourself in terms of your behavior at present versus when you were young?
So basically, being the eldest child, so we are three sisters, so being the eldest child, I was always the most responsible one, I think. So responsibility wise and maturity wise, I think I was quite matured even as a child. But one thing which has changed is, I think I used to be very short tempered when I was a child. But obviously now it's not the same. I've controlled my anger and I try to keep myself calm. So this is one of the major differences I see in myself.
Okay. Next question. On being in Nepal, in Nepalese society, basically female education paunu athawa female education ko accessibility paunu bhaneko chai ekdamai thulo issue manincha hamro desh ma, ani aza female chai euta tech sector ma hunu bhaneko chai ekdamai nai thulo nai issue ho bhaninchha aile pani haina, a few years ago ta dherai nai thulo issue manintyo. So when you were a child, how was the accessibility to education for an average young girl in computer sector? Were there any challenges in the early days of your school life?
Right. I did my schooling from DAV school, Biratnagar. And I remember when I was in class 3 or 4, we had a computer lab in school. So fortunately, our school had computer as a subject. And we had a computer lab, but 3 or 4 students would share one computer at that time. We didn't have individual computers. So, you know, 3 people would be there and we used to learn. We got practical knowledge as well in computers. We did Logo and QBasic at that time. So we were, you know, we started learning those things in our school. But I'm not sure about other schools in Biratnagar. Maybe other schools didn't have, but luckily our school had a few computers. So we got the opportunity to learn, and computer was not a subject in school. Example in SLC or CBSE also, computer was not a mandatory subject in which we were given grades. So it was just an additional subject. So probably at that time, people didn't consider it very important. But luckily in our school, we had computers. We had good computer teacher as well. And that's how I started liking programming, actually, because our teacher was also good and we got a chance to use the computer lab. So it was because of this, I think I have interest in computers specifically. And so when I was also in class 7th or 8th, I remember there was an institute here which had recently opened. It was, it's called NIIT. So it had recently opened, and then I joined that institute and I started learning web designing and animation. So I think, we still had computers and computer institutes here in Biratnagar. So it was not, I mean, if somebody wanted to learn, I don't think it was a big challenge for them. If they wanted, they could have learned. And although Biratnagar is a relatively smaller town compared to Kathmandu, so I think there were still learning opportunities because there were institutes as well. There were other smaller institutes as well who used to teach, MS-DOS and those basic things were taught at that time as well. Regarding the challenges I faced, in terms of computer, I think there were not many challenges as such, but I faced problems in other subjects. For example, till class 10th, when I was in Biratnagar, I had never been to a chemistry lab or a physics lab. And when I changed my school in 11th and went to Pune, I had chemistry as a subject. I faced major issues in practical experiments initially, as I did not know even the basics compared to other students in my class. I didn't know how to use beaker, funnel, and do any experiments that time. I was very clueless. And I could not perform my first lab experiment on my own. So my friend had to help me out. And I also had a tough time writing my first lab report. But later, when I was familiar with all this, then chemistry was one of my favorite subjects once I learned all this. So this was the challenge that I faced during that time. It was 2006, and that time I faced this challenge.
Okay, so basically practice garnu ra parnu bhane kei pani like now nai athawa kei pani impossible chai hudaina bhanne kura chai hajurko kura bata bujhyo haina. So being a girl chai hajurle kei teso challenges haru face garnu bhayo like school colleges ma haru ma like ke hune boys ko participation body hune ni ta esto ma ani tespachi chai like kasale chai alikati अलिक पुस ब्याक पुस भएको जस्तो टाइपको यस्तो कहिले फिल भयो गर्नुभयो हजुरले स्कुलमा हुँदा अथवा कलेजमा हुँदा?
No, as such, I did not face any challenge in this. I mean, in our school, in fact, the girls were always better in studies compared to boys in my class specifically till I was in 10th. So I never faced a challenge that, okay, boys are being preferred or, girls are being preferred. In fact, teachers in our school supported girls most of the time, especially at DAV school. They were always, I never faced any problem, regarding this. So it was fine.
Okay. So moving towards our next question. And so, हामी भन्छौँ नि एभ्री प्यारेन्ट्सको चाहिँ एकदम ठुलो रोल हुन्छ एउटा चाइल्डको चाहिँ सेप कसरी दिने अथवा चाइल्डको करियर कसरी सेट गर्ने अनि कसरी उसलाई चाहिँ हायर एजुकेसन्सहरूतिर चाहिँ हामी प्रमोट गर्ने भनेर भन्ने कुरामा चाहिँ हाम्रो प्यारेन्ट्सको एकदमै ठुलो रोल छ भनेर हामी भन्छौँ होइन. सो हाउ डु डिस्क्राइब द रोल अफ योर प्यारेन्ट्स इन योर अर्ली चाइल्डहुड इन सेपिङ योर इन्ट्रेस्ट इन हायर एजुकेसन एन्ड डेडिकेसन टु करियर डेभलपमेन्ट?
Okay, so for my career, I think both my parents have always encouraged me to work and become independent and make decisions on my own. So they never interfere like, okay, why are you doing this? Or why don't you do something something else? So they've always, supported me in whatever I've done. And regarding my studies, my mom, when I was in school till class 10, she helped me a lot. She would even teach me after school. She would help me understand a lot of concepts that I would miss out in school. So sometimes, in class, what happens is it's a 30 or 40 minute class and then you're able to concentrate only for first 10 minutes. I'm not sure about others, but that's what happened with me. So I would concentrate only for first 10 minutes and after that I was probably in the world. So at home, then my mom used to teach me. And so I would give a lot of credit to her for my education and my interest towards higher education and pursuing a bachelor's as well as master's. Yeah, so I would give her a lot of credit. And although my parents, they never pressurized me for studies. They always wanted me to work hard and try my best. But like my dad never considered marks only to be... to be very important in shaping your career. So, which also is true because marks is just one, you know, it's just, it does not depend on your marks whether you excel in your career or not. So he never considered that very important. So this, so I had both views in my mind because my mom and dad had different thoughts. Like my mom always was like, okay, you have to do very as, you know, you have to try your best and do as well as you can in your exams. But my father had the thought that it does not matter. I mean, just let her do what she wants, right? It does not matter much. So I had both the views in my mind, which made me a hardworking person as well as be prepared for the future. That marks alone is not responsible for your career. You have to work hard in your career as well. Yeah.
So हजुरको प्यारेन्ट्स हजुरले चाहिँ त्यो टाइममा पनि हजुरलाई धेरै नै सपोर्ट गर्नुभएको रहेछ भन्ने कुरा बुझ्यो हजुरको कुराबाट. सो एकदमै धेरै इन्सपायरिङ लाग्यो मलाई हजुरको फ्यामिली नै पनि जति हजुर इन्सपायरिङ हुनुहुन्छ. सो नेक्स्ट क्वेसन इज हामी जहाँ पनि जान्छौँ त्यहाँनिर हाम्रो केही तितो यादहरू हुन्छ, केही मिठो यादहरू हुन्छ, कुनै यस्तो कुराहरू हुन्छ जुन चाहिँ हामीलाई लाइफ टाइम कहिले पनि बिर्सिनु हुँदैन, अनि कुनै चाहिँ यस्तो कुराहरू हुन्छ जुनलाई चाहिँ हामीले पायौँ भने चाहिँ अगेन एन्ड अगेन हामीलाई फेरि पनि त्यो मोमेन्ट चाहिँ फेरि मैले पाएँ भने चाहिँ आई विल गो ब्याक भन्ने टाइपको मोमेन्ट्सहरू कति धेरै हुन्छ नि त. सो युआर एन एलुमनाई अफ अक्सफोर्ड एन्ड वार्विक युनिभर्सिटी, वाट वेयर योर अमेजिङ अनफर्गेटेबल मेमोरिज एट युके?
So I spent 4 years in the UK and my experience in the UK was amazing. And I think those were the years where I learned to live a life more independently because my parents were not there. And over there, it was not even hostel life where, you know, you have dorm parents or anybody to, you know, help you out, or so it's fully independent life. So, and most of my time was actually spent studying or cooking with friends, and in the weekends we used to go sometimes for, you know, like to other nearby cities just for a weekend trip we used to go. So that's what I did in the UK, and I was also a part of the chess club because I really enjoyed playing chess. So I was a part of that club, and there was also a Friday club at my university, and where we used to play games every Friday. So that's also one of the clubs I was a part of, and we also did other fun activities like ice skating and punting. Although I didn't really know how to do ice skating or punting, but you know, I actually participated, and that's about it, I think.
Okay, so नेपालीहरूको चाहिँ मेनली बानी कस्तो हुन्छ भने वी आर अट्याच टु आवर प्यारेन्ट्स एकदमै धेरै, अनि अलिकति बाहिर कतै जानु पर्यो अथवा अलिकति हुन्छ नि अलिकति टाढा जानु पर्यो भने त्यो चाहिँ हामीलाई एकदमै धेरै ठुलो कुरा जस्तो लाग्छ नि त. होमसिक फिल हुन्छ हामीलाई एक दुई दिनमै, होइन? सो हजुरले त्यो कुराहरूलाई चाहिँ कसरी ट्याकल गर्नुभयो?
So basically, whenever I used to go to UK for first 1 week or 10 days, I used to feel very homesick. But then I used to get used to the environment. So it was like, okay, now, you know, so then our classes used to begin. So I would be busy in that. And then I used to end up remembering about home because we had friends. So it was, I mean, only in the beginning, like, you know, when you go, and the first week was difficult, and after that it was fine. One thing I would like to say is that what I liked most about the UK was people there were very disciplined. They were always punctual and they valued time. So this is what my learning actually in the 4 years. So, you know, if you value time, it's very important to value time.
Okay. So next question is, हामी त्यो फ्यु इयर्स अगो चाहिँ एज आई अलरेडी सेड नेपालमा भनौँ न एउटा फिमेलले एजुकेसन पाउनु भन्ने नै एउटा धेरै ठुलो कुरा जस्तो लाग्थ्यो, अनि हजुरले कसरी सोच हजुरले त्यो मेन्टालिटी चाहिँ आफूले आफूलाई प्रिपेयर चाहिँ कसरी गर्नुभयो कि यस म युके जान्छु अनि त्यसपछि पढ्छु आफ्नो करियरमा यसरी सेट गर्छु भनेर चाहिँ आफूले आफूलाई मेन्टली चाहिँ कसरी प्रिपेयर गर्नुभयो हजुरले?
When I was in 11th and 12th, I was exploring opportunities. So I thought, you know, what should I be doing? I didn't know much about higher education. So I decided that, okay, this is the subject I like. So I chose a subject accordingly. And for UK, it seemed like, you know, US is like even, you know, if you see it, it takes like almost one full day to go to the US. So US was not an option for me. And I was considering UK mainly and India. So luckily, when I applied to the UK, so I got into the college I was looking for. I wanted to go to Warwick, and I got into it. So I was like, you know, there's no other question. I have to go there only. And the maths department at Warwick was really good. It was ranked among the top few. So I wanted to go there.
Okay. So what brought you back to Nepal from UK?
So actually, I did not have the intention to stay in the UK for long term. And to be honest, when I graduated, I did not have a clear idea or a clear goal about what I wanted to do next. So, and I had also been away from my family for 6 years. So I thought, you know, now let me go back home and try to figure out what I need to do. So that's the reason I came back home to Nepal, to spend time with family as well as to figure out what needs to be done next.
Okay, so हजुरले चाहिँ युकेबाट ब्याक हुँदा नै नेपालमा गएर के काम गर्छु भन्ने चाहिँ हजुरको मेन्टालिटी प्रिपेयर गरिरहनु भएको थियो हजुरले भनेपछि.
Right, right. And then I joined my father's business. So I was learning there for about 1 year. So I learned a lot over there as well.
Okay. So अहिलेसम्म पनि हामीले हेर्दाखेरि चाहिँ अहिलेसम्म पनि हामीले अब भनौँ न हाम्रै कलेज अथवा युनिभर्सिटिजहरूमा गएर हेर्दाखेरि पनि टेकमा चाहिँ गर्ल्सको पार्टिसिपेसन चाहिँ एकदमै थोरै देखिन्छ कि. गर्ल्सहरू चाहिँ अलिकति आफ्नै क्यापासिटीमा क्वेसन गर्ने टाइपको पनि देखिन्छ होइन. यो टेक रियली मेरै लागि बनायो त भन्ने टाइपको पनि देखिन्छ. फ्यु इयर्स अगो त धेरै नै थियो होला, अलिकति गर्ल्सको पार्टिसिपेसन एकदमै कम थियो होला. अहिलेसम्म पनि देखिन्छ त्यो, अब जबहरूमा देखिन्छ अथवा कलेजहरूमा गयो एकदमै थोरै गर्ल्सहरू देखिन्छ. सो हाउ डिड टेक बिकम योर चोइस अफ करियर? वाज इट अलवेज वाट यु एस्पायर्ड अर यु वेन्ट थ्रु अ फ्यु स्वर्व्स अलोङ द वे?
Tech was actually not always my choice of career. I explored other areas as well. I did internships at banks and even tried teaching. But ever since I was a child, I being from a business family, I wanted to do something of my own, but I was not very clear what I wanted to do. And I also enjoyed being on the computer all the time. So even after school, when I was a child, I used to come home and spend, you know, 1 or 2 hours on the computer. That was considered as a refreshment for me. So, you know, using the computer, doing something on the computer, that was refreshment for me. So I always enjoyed computers and I always wanted to do business, being from a business family. So that's the reason I think I chose this career option. And when I went to India and I was working there in the data science sector, then I realized that, yeah, I'm actually enjoying this. So this is what I should be getting involved with.
सो हजुरलाई हजुरले जसरी भन्नुभयो ब्याङ्कमा पनि काम गरेँ एन्ड टिचिङ पनि गरेँ, त्यो कामहरू गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ हजुरलाई किन चाहिँ यो चाहिँ मेरो लागि बनेको होइन, जस्तो चाहिँ यो चाहिँ आइएम नट इन्जोइङ अथवा यो चाहिँ होइन मेरो लागि होइन, मैले अर्कै केही काम गरिराख्नु पर्ने हो, यो चाहिँ मेरो लागि होइन भनेर चाहिँ कति बेला फिल भयो अनि के कुराले चाहिँ हजुरलाई त्यस्तो फिल भयो?
राइट, सो व्हेन आई वाज एट ब्याङ्क I did internships only at 2 banks here in Biratnagar. So probably I did not learn enough that time. If I would have learned enough, if I had more idea, I would have been like, okay, bank is the right sector for me. Banking is the right sector for me. And for teaching as well, teaching, I think I enjoyed teaching. It was not like I didn't enjoy teaching. Given a chance, I would, you know, like to teach again. So teaching is something I enjoyed, but I think I liked computers more. There's a lot of scope in technology if you think about it. So each sector, I mean, whatever sectors we have, each sector, we can build a technology around that sector. So there are a lot of challenging problems that are yet not solved. And I think it can be solved through technology. So, I mean, the scope is also very wide. So that's the reason I think technology, even for other people, it's a good career option.
Yeah, ma'am. एकदमै लाज फिल भएको एकदमै एकदमै राम्रो मानिन्छ अहिले टेक फिल्डलाई. सो अहिले हजुर जुन पोजिसनमा हुनुहुन्छ अहिले चाहिँ हजुरलाई जुन चाहिँ एउटा एकदम राम्रो उसले चाहिँ चिनिन्छ होइन, हजुरलाई एकदमै मोटिभेटिङ इन्सपायरिङ मान्छेको रूपमा चाहिँ हामीले लिइरहेको छौँ होइन. सो यु आर फाउन्डर एन्ड डाइरेक्टर अफ डेल्टा टेक, अ सफ्टवेयर डेभलपमेन्ट कम्पनी. एज यु लुक ब्याक, विच इज द थिङ द्याट मोटिभेटेड यु टु स्टार्ट युर ओन कम्पनी?
So, like I mentioned, like most of my family members run their own companies. So ever since I was a child, I knew ultimately, you know, even if I do a job or work as a teacher or anything else, ultimately I want to start something of my own someday. And I still remember whenever we had some essay writing in school about, you know, what are your career and career goals and ambitions. I would always write about how I would start something of my own someday and give career opportunities to other people. So that was something which I always had, that okay, I want to start something of my own.
Okay, so as Azrul is born, family pani business oriented. So Azrul is like, family business is join gada unsa jasto chai Azrul lai kina lagena. Azrul lai kina ma afnai company kholchu bhaneko jasto chai tyo inspiration bhaneko ta ekdamai thulo inspiration bhayo ni ta tyo time ko jati bela chai Azrul le aba jati bela chai aba women lai chai euta alikati garna sakdainus bhanne type ko hamro society cha haina euta boundaries ma bandhne type ko society cha. So Azrul lai kina chai ma hoina ma chai ke garchu भने आफ्नै एउटा कम्पनी खोल्छु अनि त्यसपछि बस्छु भन्ने कुरा चाहिँ त्यो इन्स्पिरेसन चाहिँ हजुरलाई कहाँबाट आयो अनि कसरी आयो?
So like I said that I wanted something of my own, right? And joining my family business, there would be, I mean, I'm sure there are a lot of challenges, but there are already, you know, people responsible for it's already, you know, like my father is responsible for a certain business, right? So for me, at that particular time, I thought there won't be something new, I would say. Like if I start my own company, then I would start something from scratch. I would know the challenges faced by a new business. And if it's an old company, I would know the day-to-day challenges definitely and how to resolve the day-to-day challenges. But starting a new company, I would know, okay, what happens initially. And then later on, I can run the company as well. So it's, you know, that's the reason I wanted to start something. And then we didn't have a tech. My dad is not into technology, right? So I wanted to get into technology as well. So our group is now also into technology, and I was interested in technology and not really in manufacturing at that particular time. So that's the reason I started my own company.
So you love challenges.
Yeah, if we had a technology technological company or a software company, I would have joined the same because I like technology. Maybe I would have started another project or something to give me a feel that, okay, this is what happens when you start something from scratch. So that's the reason, you know, I started my own company.
So that's very inspiring. Jun society ma chai girls harle chai tech ma kaam garnu pani euta thulo issue ko rupma lekhincha. Jun society ma chai girls ra boys ko beech ma nai job salary ko beech ma nai difference garincha, tya chai hajurle euta company kholera chai hazarau testo manche harlai chai hajurle job ditaunu bhako cha. Tyo bhanda thulo inspiring kura aru kehi pani huna sakdaina jasto lagcha malai. So your company provides development services and also has a range of your own product line, Delta Sales App, Delta CRM, and more. Why did you choose to delve into both service as well as product development sectors?
So basically, when we started in 2016, 5 years ago, we were mainly in the service based. We were mainly a service based company. We used to get projects and deliver it to our clients. Basically this gave me an opportunity to understand about the tech solution that companies were mainly looking for. And we realized that tracking sales team and their performance was one common problem which many companies in Nepal were facing. So what we thought was, okay, why not build a software which can solve problems of multiple companies, and it will make it cost effective for those companies as well. So the companies which approached us did not want a customized solution for themselves because it was very expensive for them to build one solution only for them. So we thought, why not, you know, build a common solution? So that's the reason we built Delta Sales App, which is a SaaS based solution for specifically for sales teams. So it is customizable to fit into various businesses. So that's the reason we got into product as well. And regarding why we are into both services and products, it's because I think I see opportunities in both, so products as well as services. So if we have separate teams, I don't think there is any conflict in getting into both product and services.
Yeah, ma'am. And so what are the three most rewarding things that impel you to continue your journey as a company founder or director?
So the main thing is that there's learning. I get to learn a lot every day, something new every day. And the second thing is that I'm able to give career opportunities in the tech sector in a place like Biratnagar. That's the second thing. And the third would be that it gives me, you know, immense satisfaction when I see that our app is being used by so many companies to solve their real problems. So that is that's one thing which I that's very rewarding for me.
Okay, so आजुले पहिला भन्नुभयो अनुसार हजुरको हजुरमा एकदमै ठुलो भनौँ फ्यामिली रेस्पोन्सिबिलिटी पनि थियो भनेर भन्नुभयो अनि हजुर त्यही भएर चाहिँ सानैदेखि हल्का म्याच्योर्ड एन्ड रेस्पोन्सिबल हुँदै जानुभयो भनेर भन्नुभयो होइन. सो फ्यामिली अनि वर्क यो सबै ब्यालेन्स गर्नलाई चाहिँ हामी नेपालीलाई चाहिँ स्पेसियली एकदमै गाह्रो हुन्छ कि किनभने हामी फ्यामिलीलाई पनि सँगसँगै लान खोज्छौँ अनि कामलाई पनि सँगसँगै लान्छौँ हाम्रो अरू कुरा पनि हामी सँगसँगै गरिरहेको हुन्छ नि त. सो what is your mantra for maintaining work life balance?
So to be honest, actually I don't think I have a very good work life balance. I'm slightly workaholic, but I think it's very important to have a good work life balance for you know everybody should have, and even I'm trying and working towards it. I'm trying to give more time towards my family as well, but I'm slightly workaholic, yeah.
सो हजुरले गरिरहनु भएको उसमा चाहिँ हजुरलाई के चाहिँ पुगेन जस्तो लाग्छ? हजुरले फ्यामिलीलाई लेस प्रायोरिटी दिइरहनु भएको छ अहिले जस्तो लाग्छ कि कामलाई बढी कामलाई चाहिँ कम प्रायोरिटी भइरहेछ कि अथवा अरू कुनै कुराहरू छ जुन चाहिँ लाइफमा पछाडि छुटिरहेछ त्यस्तो के छ म्याम हजुरको?
Not, I mean, what I would say is because I work a lot, then I have forgotten about my, you know, like hobbies or passion. I don't give any time to other things other than my work is like first and then my family and then the other things like example chess, right? I used to be a part of the chess club. I've since 5 years I've not played chess. So, you know, so that's the, so basically, you know, if I had a good work-life balance, I would have spent time pursuing my hobbies as well. So I mean I'll try to work towards it, but I have like I set goals and sometimes I feel like okay I need to first achieve my goal and then I can you know spend time doing other things. So that's the reason probably I'm not able to maintain a proper work life balance.
So any suggestions to our viewers how kasari chai hamle hamro work life balance lai esari chai maintain garda ramro huncha bhanne type ko hajurlai ke maile yo garna paako bhaye chai sayad maintain hunthyo hola bhanne jasto euta huncha ni aafai lai suggestions haru aidako huncha tara tyo implement ko hamle garna sakirako hudaina ni testo kehi cha hajur sanga?
Yeah, what I feel is like on weekends during weekends we should spend time with our family and during weekdays we should keep it solely for work and so that way I think one can maintain work life balance and during weekends you can also pursue your hobbies or whatever you want to you know work on other than work.
So ma'am, what are your other hobbies like chess pan bhayo ta tyo bike aru ke hobbies haru hajurko?
So as such, you know, because I used to like drawing as well, but you know, like again since 7-8 years I've never done it. So you know, I've forgotten about my hobbies. And other than that, I like, so during my spare time, even now, so I like exploring the internet. I like to see what new apps have come and what are the new improvements in technology. So, so that's my, you know, that's something I do in my free time. And other than that, I like traveling as well. So every few months I'll be like, I like to travel with my family. So during that time, that's family time.
So moving towards our next question, what are the top three suggestions you would give to women who aspire to start and run their own tech ventures in Nepal?
Right. So the first thing I would like to say is that we need to hire the best possible talent. That will really help. Second is you might face challenges along the way, but one should not feel demotivated. And one should also have short-term goals as well as long-term goals for the company. So that's what I feel, yeah.
Okay, so I have another question for you, ma'am. So हजुरले यत्रो कति धेरै कामहरू गर्नुभयो, एउटा आफै कम्पनी कम्पनी खोल्नु भएको छ होइन, सो हजुरले अरू फिमेल्सहरूलाई चाहिँ केही कुरा भन्नु पर्यो, यो चाहिँ यसरी हुन्छ है भनेर चाहिँ, यो कुरा चाहिँ मैले यो टाइममा गरेको भयो अथवा हजुरले जति बेला पढ्दै हुनुहुन्थ्यो होइन, अब हाम्रो भ्युयर्सहरू कति धेरैजना स्टुडेन्ट्सहरू पनि हुनुहुन्छ, सो हजुरले पढिरहनु भएको बेला चाहिँ मैले यो गरेको भए चाहिँ सायद आज मैले अझ अझ बढी गर्न सक्थेँ होला भनेको जस्तो, त्यस्तो केही कुरा छ म्याम?
See that, I think that always happens if you, like when you go back to the past and think, okay, if I had done this, then this would have happened. But then that does not really help, right? I think we should just live in the present and think about the near future and not think about the past that, okay, if I had done this, this would have happened. Because sometimes what happens is like I can, you know, anybody in Biratnagar can give an excuse that, okay, I'm in Biratnagar, that's the reason I'm not successful. That's the reason I'm not able to, you know, do as much as people in other countries. That's the reason. But I think that's just an excuse for yourself to make you feel better that, okay, this, you know, that it's just to make you feel better that, okay, you're not that successful because you're not in a good place. But I don't think that matters, according to me. That's just to satisfy yourself. So I what I think is you should not think much about the past, just think about the present that, okay, this is what you have done so far and what you need to do in the immediate future. And yeah, and maybe have some short term and long term goals, because what has happened, you cannot change that.
Yeah, ma'am. So we are at the end of our session and this is our Q&A session. So if you have any questions, please let me know on the comment section. So we have our question, ma'am, in the chat section. So, हजुर यहाँ हुनुहुन्थ्यो र हजुरले चाहिँ डिफ्रेन्ट डिफ्रेन्ट कन्ट्रिजहरू पनि अरू कन्ट्रिजहरू पनि भिजिट गर्नुभएको छ है, सो वाट काइन्ड अफ डिफरेन्स हजुरले कस्तो टाइपको डिफरेन्सहरू फेस गर्नुभयो यहाँ हुँदा र फरेन कन्ट्रिजहरूमा हुँदा?
The main, not exactly foreign countries, because all countries are different, I think. So specifically UK compared to Nepal, because I stayed there for 4 years, so I know more about UK compared to other countries. So there people are more disciplined and they value time. And here it's like, okay, if you say, okay, you'll be there at, you know, like 5 o'clock. So it's like 5:15. Or 5:20, but over there, if it's 5 o'clock, and even if you're 2 minutes late, you will, you know, inform the other person, okay, I'm running 2 minutes late. So that's the key difference between, you know, Nepal and the UK.
Yes, ma'am. जहिले पनि जोक भन्दाखेरि पनि नेपालको टाइम हो नि त भन्ने चलन छ हाम्रो होइन, सो एज अ फिमेल चाहिँ हजुरले के डिफरेन्स पाउनु भयो त यहाँ र फरेन कन्ट्रीमा?
As a female, like, I mean, in the UK, when I was in the UK, so it was, so over there also in terms of like mathematics or technology, there also it was similar because less girls were involved in the subject which I was doing. So in my class, probably only 30% or 20 to 30% were girls and rest all were boys. And for me, I did not find much difference, you know, in this girls, boys. I mean, as such, I did not face anything in anywhere, even in the UK and even in Nepal.
Okay, ma'am. So, हजुरले जब गरिरहेको थिएँ ब्याङ्कमा भनेर भन्नुभयो, त्यहाँनिर के डिफरेन्स पाउनुभयो हजुरले? किनभने नेपालमा चाहिँ के भनिन्छ भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ एउटा दुवैजनाले चाहिँ दुवैजना लाइक केटा र केटीले चाहिँ दुवैजना एउटै उसमा चाहिँ काम गरिरहेको छ भने पनि स्यालेरी चाहिँ डिफ्रेन्ट दिइन्छ भनेर भन्ने कुराहरू पनि धेरै सुनिरहेको हुन्छु मैले होइन, लाइक एउटा केटालाई चाहिँ धेरै स्यालेरी अनि केटीलाई चाहिँ थोरै स्यालेरी, त्यस्तो टाइपको कुराहरू पनि धेरै सुनिरहेको हुन्छ, सो के भएको थियो हजुरसँग यस्तो केही इन्सिडेन्ट भएको थियो?
Right. So back then, I mean, I don't know about what salary others were getting, but what I would like to say is that mainly what I saw was generally in the customer service department, girls would be there, right? And other work was done mainly by boys. So that was one of the differences I found in the banking sector. So it was, girls were always, you know, into, you know, the customers were there and then they had to handle the customers. Maybe because girls are polite and nobody can shout on, you know, actually scream on girls or something. That's the reason why they put girls over there. But that was the difference I found in the banking sector. But nobody was into, you know, the manager role or something. I did not find any girls in the two banks I worked for.
Yeah, okay, ma'am. So, as you say, as a business woman, say you know, in province one, ma. So province one, ma, bako border, say, costo ki costo difficulties, or say, as you face kari rana bako sa. Panale, or kune province ma boyde ko boy, say, you faida malai onthio. Taro tisu type ko case province one ma boyde, say, alkati ki boyo banne ko costo halko difficulties, or sa province one ma.
The main difficulty we find is like lack of talent and resources here in Biratnagar, because most of the tech companies are based out of Kathmandu. So nobody wants to move from Kathmandu to Biratnagar. And in Kathmandu, there are a lot of tech companies. So even for people, there's a lot of opportunities, which is not in Biratnagar. So that's the reason here, there are not many, you know, we don't find talent here. So that's the main issue we face as a company. But having said that, I mean, what we have done is we have hired people in Kathmandu as well. So that's the solution we found. So they are working from home and it's working out well.
Okay. So Azuli challenges or you say province fan ma bako bhayo ra hajurle jasto bhanu bhayo haina chai mancheharu alikati tyo experienced haru ma alikati kami nai huncha hala. So हजुरले चाहिँ त्यो च्यालेन्जेसहरूलाई ओभरकम गर्नलाई चाहिँ अरू के मेथड्सहरू गरिरहनु भएको छ, जस्तै एउटा भन्नुभयो होमबाट काम गरिरहनु भएको छ भनेर, तर घरबाट इम्प्लोइले काम गर्दाखेरि पनि त धेरै सोर्स अफ अब च्यालेन्जेसहरू हुन्छ होला, कति धेरै कुरामा गाह्रो हुन्छ होला. सो यो कुराहरूलाई चाहिँ हजुरले कसरी ओभरकम गरिरहनु भएको छ?
राइट. सो वर्किङ फ्रम होम, बिकज यु नो सिन्स लास्ट वान एन्ड हाफ इयर्स इट्स बिन यु नो मोस्ट अफ द टाइम पिपल हेभ बिन वर्किङ फ्रम होम एन्ड इट्स अ च्यालेन्ज इन टर्म्स अफ कम्युनिकेसन. बट वाट वी डु इज we communicate, you know, almost regularly. We have a set of goals. So in technology specifically, it does not matter whether you work from home or office. Once you understand the requirements, I don't think it matters where you work from, as long as you're working. So that's one thing. And the second thing what we tried was from various schools in Biratnagar as well as around Biratnagar, we hired interns and, you know, we give them 3 months internship or 2 months internship. And at the end of the internship, they can work with us for the next 1 or 2 years. And I'm happy to say that, you know, people who have joined us as interns, let's say 4 years back today, they have a very successful career. So whether they are here working with us or other companies, they have a successful career.
Okay, ma'am. So hamro audience le say hajurko experience as a business woman bhanidinu na bhanera bhanu bhako cha. So hajurko experience kasto cha as a business woman?
So I think, I even did a job, right? I like mentioned before, for 2 years and business. So what the key difference is that in job, you have your manager or your superior to define your goals and objectives. But in business, you have to define your own goals. You have to define the company goals, right? So that's the key difference. And I think you have to work harder and you don't know whether, you know, there's nobody to tell you, okay, whether you're doing well or not. I mean, how do you define whether, you know, you're doing well or not? But in terms of when you're doing a job, you know that, okay, if your superiors are happy, if your colleagues are happy, then you are doing well, right? So that's the difference. So here there's nobody to say, okay, whether you're doing well or not. How do you define that? Whether you're doing extremely well or you're doing average, you know, you have to define it on your own.
Yes, ma'am. So you sound like so confident and you are so confident and hajur chai euta inspiration nai bannu bhako cha hami sabai jana ko lagi haina jati pani viewers haru hununcha jati pani girls haru hununcha waha ko lagi chai hajur le chai you can do it hai bhanera chai euta path set garirahnu bhako cha ani ta basically. So hajur sanga yo confidence ki ma chai kasako lagi inspiration banna sakchu bhanne type confidence kasari aayo ani yo confidence kasari build garne hola hajur le aru females haru lai chai ke suggestion dinuhuncha?
So basically once you I'm not really sure like how to answer this because it comes from within, right? So earlier when I was a child, I was not very confident. But you have to keep trying a little more than what you can. For example, this is the first time I'm doing a live, you know, thing on Facebook. If you would have asked me the same thing 10 years ago, I wouldn't have been able to do. So you have to just try and you know, do something which you find challenging, and then what happens is you gradually build that confidence. So if you feel, no, I cannot do this, but you can do, you know, you can try it a little bit, and if you feel, yeah, you are able to do it, then why not? I'm sure you'll be able to do it.
Yes, ma'am. So, कहिले काहीँ हुन्छ नि उता ट्राई सो हार्ड फर समथिङ होइन एकदमै धेरै चाहिँ आई वन्ट टु डु दिस आई वन्ट टु अचिभ दिस भन्ने हुन्छ अनि कतिचोटि हामीले कति धेरै प्र्याक्टिसहरू गरिरहेको हुन्छौँ कति धेरै ट्राई गर्छौँ होइन त्यो कुरा अचिभ गर्नलाई तर हामीले चाहिँ त्यो कुरा पाउँदैनौँ कि भनेको एकदमै धेरै हार्डवर्कबाट पनि हामीले नपाइरहेको हुन्छ त्यति बेला चाहिँ कन्फिडेन्स एकदमै लो हुन जान्छ अनि त्यस्तो केही इन्सिडेन्ट भएको छ हजुरसँग अनि छ भने छैन भने पनि त्यसलाई ओभरकम गर्नलाई के गर्नु पर्ला हजुरको सजेसन के होला
Yeah, so that happens, you know, with everybody, I think. Nobody is ever satisfied with what they have achieved, I think. So, like in business also, so while I'm working in technology, so I have a particular goal for a month, right? So most of the time, you know, everybody is very overambitious. They think that, okay, we can do this, let's achieve this so-and-so goal. But most of the time for me, it's like, you know, I achieve less than what I have done. So for me, it's like, you know, I don't achieve how much I have targeted. So what you said, that confidence should be low in that case. But no, even if you have achieved something, right, like maybe 20 to 30%, it's not like demotivating. One day you will reach your goal. It's not like the end. So, you know, you have to keep trying. You have to keep trying and keep trying until you reach your goal. So, and not be demotivated that, okay, you could not reach your goal this time. So that happens all the time, I think.
Yes, ma'am. So as business women, we see people tend not to hear you as they search for male counterpart every time. At least that's what I have faced bhannubhayeko cha hamro viewerle. So how do you handle such situation and how to negotiate those clients bhanera bhannubhayeko cha?
I didn't get your question. Could you repeat the first line, please? I didn't get it.
Yes, ma'am, sure. As a woman in business, we see people tend not to hear you as they search for a male counterpart every time. That's what I have faced. How do you handle such situation and how to negotiate those clients?
Okay, so I think I have not faced something like that in when I was working. So whenever to any client, and you know, if you show confidence to the client that yes, your company can achieve this, then you know, they are ready to give the project to us. It's not like if another person who is a male would be speaking, then they would have given the project to that person. Because you talk about the company, you're the face of the company, right? You don't say that, okay, it's only, you know, if you tell, okay, it's because they also know that if it's a company, there'll be a mix of boys and girls, and it's not just girls working. But you have to build a good portfolio, and you have to show the client, you have to tell them that, okay, I work for the other clients also, and they liked my work. This is what the other clients tell about my work. If they're still not convinced, ask your old clients to actually have, you know, ask them for testimonials, a video testimonial, how you helped them out. And that's how you're going to build your portfolio. So you can showcase that to other clients who will, you know, have trust in you. So not for male or female, but what was challenging is in the beginning when we launched this, our Delta Sales app, our product. So we found it very challenging to get our first customer. It was very difficult. So, but we kept on trying. It was not like we gave up. It took us nearly like 4 to 5 months to get our first customer. So, but if we would have, lost hope in that first 6 months, then I don't think we would have, been able to, reach where we are today for that particular product. So we had to try a lot and not give up that, okay, now nobody is, using this product. So we might as well, stop this product. So that should not happen. So even if others are not believing you, you have to believe in yourself, and you have to build a portfolio or your client testimonials in such a manner that others can also trust you, whether you are a boy or a girl.
यस म्याम सो हाम्रो नेपालमा जुन ट्रेन्ड छ लाइक बोइजले चाहिँ यो गर्न सक्ने अनि गर्ल्सले चाहिँ यो गर्न नसक्ने टाइपको त्यो एउटा माइन्ड सेट चाहिँ सेट गरिराखेको छ नि अनि गर्ल्सहरूलाई चाहिँ जुन सोसियल रेस्ट्रिक्सन्सहरूमा बाँधेर राखेको छ नि यो सोसाइटीले अनि जब पनि कुनै पनि एउटा केटी चाहिँ लाइक म गर्छु भनेर चाहिँ एउटा अफिसहरूमा जाँदाखेरि चाहिँ जुन प्रब्लम हजुरले फेस गर्नु भएन त्यो चाहिँ नेपालमा मोस्टली गर्ल्सहरूले फेस गरिरहनु भएको छ होइन सो एउटा वुमेन भइसके पछाडि चाहिँ हरेक कुरामा के भनौँ न एउटा मेल काउन्टर पार्ट चाहिँ त्यहाँनिर चाहिँ केही न केही चाहिँ हुने टाइपको हुन्छ नि योवालालाई चाहिँ हजुरले के भन्न चाहनुहुन्छ यस्तो कम्पनीहरूलाई अनि यो जुन ट्रेन्ड चलिरहेको छ यो ट्रेन्डलाई चाहिँ हजुरले के भन्न चाहनुहुन्छ बिङ अ फिमेल
I think that has been going on since, you know, very long time, and so it is very difficult to change, and the change has to come if you know, like everybody has to change, even parents have to change. Yeah, so the way parents will treat their kids, that's how their kids are going to treat their kids, and that's how it's going to change. So if parents itself treat their kids in a different manner, like, you know, not distinguishing between girls and boys, then I think it can change. Gradually it will change. It will not change in one day. It cannot happen.
So you think parents le nai first dekhi nai boys or girls ma chai differences nasikaune ho bhanne chai yo kura hudaina.
Right, right. So if that happens, then ultimately, you know, maybe after 10, 20 years, that it will, there'll be no difference, right?
Yes, ma'am. So ma'am, I want to know best moment of your career.
Best moment of my career. Yes. There's no best moment of my career as such, but because every day is a new challenge, and I there's no best moment as such so far. But yeah, definitely, if we have, let's say, 10,000 clients using our Delta Sales app product, then that will be a milestone that we will reach. So that's the ultimate goal. But so far, there's no, I mean, I cannot recall any like favorite moment or something like that.
Okay, ma'am. So, Azur say, abo, tyo, UK ma pani Azur le ta UK chhodera Nepal aisaknu bhayo, dherai barsha bhaisakyo kaam garisaknu bhayo, haina? So, abo feri ma back chai tyo time ma jana paunthe bhanera bhan pani, Azur le chai ke kura chha feri repeat garna chahanuhuncha? त्यो मोमेन्ट सम्झिनु भयो भने चाहिँ ओहो द्याट वाज अ गोल्डन पिरियड टाइपको हुन्छ नि हामीलाई मोमेन्टहरू सम्झिँदा कुन मोमेन्ट चाहिँ मलाई फेरि पनि गर्न मन छ भनेको टाइपको कुनै मोमेन्ट छ हजुरको
या सो स्कुल लाइफ वाज द बेस्ट लाइफ आई थिङ्क बिकज यु नो यु डोन्ट हेभ एनी रेस्पोन्सिबिलिटिज यु क्यान डु वाट एभर यु लाइक यु क्यान यु जस्ट हेभ टु स्टडी राइट द्याट्स द ओन्ली थिङ यु सपोज टु डु सो आई थिङ्क आई वुड लाइक टु गो ब्याक टु माई स्कुल लाइफ स्पेसली माई हस्टेल लाइफ इन 11th एन्ड 12th Those were the best years of my life, those 2 years, because we had a lot of fun with friends in hostel. So yeah, those 2 years basically.
Okay, so we have question in our Facebook Live too. Did lockdown affect your business? What changes did you have to make, Pandubako sir?
Yes, so lockdown did affect our business. So what happened was our app was mainly for field salespeople. So what happened, we started our business in Delta Sales app was started in 2018 towards the end. And like I mentioned that after, it took us nearly 5 months to get our first client. And when we got our first client and then till the lockdown, it was almost 7-8 months. And once the lockdown happened, nobody wanted to use our app because it was mainly for the field salespeople. And if the field salespeople are not on the field, why is somebody going to use the app? So that was one of the major, you know, that was a problem. And what we did was we made an app. Then we decided to make an app for the customers itself. So the earlier what used to happen was that field salespeople go to various customers and place orders for the companies. But what we did was we released a customer app which could be used by the customer itself and place order to the companies directly. So we had to make some change. I mean, we had to launch another app to support our main Delta Sales app. And other than this, we also had to look into, you know, various countries which did not go under lockdown and focus on getting customers from those countries. So that was the minor, you know, changes we did.
So how do you foresee the future of tech in Nepal? Our question.
I think there's a lot of. I think there's a lot of scope for tech in Nepal because there are, compared to what we had like even 5 years ago when I started and now, there's a lot of talent, I think, and people are getting into technology. There are a lot of courses also now in technology. And because there's a lot of scope, I think it will do well in Nepal as well.
Okay, so, did lockdown affect your business? Yes. Where do you see yourself in next 5 years?
So in the next 5 years, I think I'll probably be doing the same thing. My company, but my targets would be to Like I told, I have some long-term and short-term goals as well. So what I would see is, you know, my app is being used in many countries with many customers, especially Delta say that, and I also foresee that, okay, we will build some more apps. And I cannot say, okay, we'll build this app next, because if I find a very interesting problem and I feel I can find customers who will be willing to use our app or solution, then I'll be building more solutions for them. So, and yeah, that's the thing I would be doing in the next 5 years. I think I'll be continuing with this.
Okay, so there are a lot of companies in Nepal in software development. What worked for you today you are so successful? What suggestions would you give to women starting business?
So I think I'm not that successful. I think there are a lot of companies, they are very successful. We are still in the early phases, I would say. And success is yet to come for us, yes.
Okay, ma'am. So, Julie, suggestions, sekhi din huncha ta aru jo man women haru chai aba business start gardai hununcha waha haruko lagi suggestions ke hola?
So basically, hiring good people, the best possible people, is very important in tech, because it's not like you are buying some something. It's hiring people. People are the ones who will shape your company. So that's the most important.
So kunai pani manchhe hire garda kheri chai hajurle waha ma herni huncha ni dherai kura haru herinchha waha like waha ko personality herinchha waha lai kati ko waha ko communication skills haru herinchha hajurle chai kunai pani manchhe hire garda kheri chai waha ma herne sab bhanda most important kura chai ke hola?
For a tech role specifically, we have, you know, 2 or 3 rounds of interview for a tech role. And what we do is, in technology, we are looking for logic. That's the main thing we look for, because if somebody is not logical, they won't be able to excel in tech. They need to know algorithms. So logic is very important. The second thing is, we see how they can communicate with us as well as the team. So that's the reason we have a few rounds of interviews. So communication is very important, how they communicate with us as a team member. And we also look for other skills, like, you know, whether they have experience building good products. We also see one more thing, if they have if somebody's experience, how long they have worked for the previous company. That's also quite important for us. Yeah.
So hajurko company ma kati jana female members haru kati jana hununcha?
There are very few female members compared to the male members. There are very few. We are about only, including myself, we are 4 people, I think 4.
Okay. So, jo jo females haru hununcha, waharu like alikati hununcha, jo jo tech field ma hununcha, haina waharu chai maile garna sakchu ki sakdina huncha ni afnai capacity ma alikati huna ta boundaries harle garda kheri pani hola, haina afule afla question garne ta tei bhayera pani ho ni ta hami kasari raise bhako sam tyo kura le ni ekdam matter garcha. So hajur ke bhanna chahanuhuncha tyo girls harlai chai inspire garnuko lagi, haina jo girls haru chai maile garna sakchu ra bhanne type ko chai question chai afule afulai sodera basnu bhayeko cha, waharulai ke bhanna chahanuhuncha?
I would say that, you know, girls are specifically in my short experience of 5 years, what I've seen is girls are more disciplined, and if you assign them a work, that will be most 90% of the time you will get that work done. But compared to boys, not everybody, I'm not giving a general statement here, but compared to boys, you'll find still 20-30% of people, they will not achieve everything that you have asked for, and maybe if they achieve it, will not be in a very organized manner. Girls will try to organize things well, and it will be delivered in a very organized manner.
Okay, so how important it is to have a gender balance workforce in a company?
It is very important, I think, but if we don't find the right talent, then it's very difficult to hire girls, right? Because first thing is the skill. I will not see, okay, whether he's a boy or a girl. If the skills match, I will hire them. We cannot hire based on whether somebody is a girl or a boy. We have to see the skills. We have to see whether they communicate well or not. And based on if it's a good fit for a company, it does not matter whether it's a boy or a girl.
Okay, ma'am. So, हजुरले अब गर्ल्सहरू चाहिँ जति पनि हुनुहुन्छ नि वी ह्याभ कति धेरै ट्यालेन्टेड गर्ल्सहरू होइन कति धेरै हुनुहुन्छ अनि उहाँहरू चाहिँ एउटा भनौँ न त्यो जेन्डरको चाहिँ एउटा बायस भएको भएर पनि होइन उहाँहरू चाहिँ अलिकति अगाडि बढ्न डराउने अलिकति मैले गर्न सक्छु कि सक्दिनँ भन्ने टाइपको क्वेसनमा चाहिँ अल्झिने गर्ने भइरहनु भएको छ होइन सो त्यो त्यो सबै हजुरले भन्नुभयो. प्यारेन्ट्सको चाहिँ एकदमै धेरै हामीलाई जुन इन्भाइरोमेन्टमा चाहिँ हुर्काइन्छ बढाइन्छ त्यो कुराले पनि हाम्रो माइन्डसेटमा चाहिँ एफेक्ट गरेको हो भनेर भन्नुभयो होइन. सो हजुरले प्यारेन्ट्सहरूलाई चाहिँ के भन्न चाहनुहुन्छ, हजुरको सजेसन्सहरू अथवा फिडब्याक्सहरू जुन प्यारेन्ट्सलाई दिनुपर्ने हुन्छ एज अ फिमेल एज अ मदर यु सुड डु दिस, किनभने मेरो ममले यो गर्नुभएको थियो र म आज यहाँ छु भन्ने टाइपको कुरा गर्नुभयो नि त हजुर. आज जहाँ पनि हुनुहुन्छ हजुरको ममले गर्दा हुनुहुन्छ. सो प्यारेन्ट्सले चाहिँ के गर्नु पहिला त यो कुरामा चाहिँ के चाहिँ काम गर्दा राम्रो होला जस्तो लाग्छ हजुरलाई?
टु एन्करेज देयर यु नो चिल्ड्रेन टु स्टडी वर्क हार्ड एज वेल एज आई मिन टिच देम आई मिन मोटिवेट देम टु बिकम मोर इन्डिपेन्डेन्ट एन्ड नॉट डिपेंड ऑन समबडी एल्स. लाइक यू हैव टू ट्राई एंड मोटिवेट देम टू बी इंडिपेंडेंट एंड हैव देयर ओन एम्स एंड एम्बिशंस.
अब हाम्रो नेपाली उसमा चाहिँ कस्तो खालको एउटा माइन्ड सेट कस्तो पनि देख्न सकिन्छ भने चाहिँ एउटा गर्ल चाहिँ अब 20 to 21 years लागिसके पछाडि चाहिँ राधर दान पढ्नुभन्दा राधर दान यो पढाइमा फोकस गर्नुभन्दा अथवा आफ्नो करियरमा चाहिँ फोकस गर्नुभन्दा चाहिँ यु सुड गेट म्यारिड भन्ने टाइपको चाहिँ एकदम त्यो टाइपको मेन्टालिटी एकदम धेरै पाइन्छ नि त. सो यो कुरामा चाहिँ हजुरको भनाइ के छ?
I think you know it there's no nothing like right time to get married because if you see I'm even I'm not married and so even I'm like 30 plus but I'm still not married so I don't think you know it matters, the age does not matter. So first thing I mean it even if you get married at 21 it's not wrong, you can get married if you know if you find the right person and who can actually help you in your career as well. It's not like I mean whatever goals you have in life you should be able to achieve them even after you're getting married. So that's what I would like to say. So it's not like you know it's not wrong or right to get married at any age, I think.
Yeah, but after you get married hajurko chai family responsibilities haru eta sabai responsibilities haru thapine bhako bhayera chai life chai some years back dhakalincha bhanera bhaninchha ni ta agadi badhna sakinthyo ho yo bhako bhayera chai jun force garincha ni parents haru le chai bata chai jun force airako huncha now you are in the age to get married bhanera haina jun tyo huncha tyo kura ma chai ke bhanna chahanu huncha hajurle?
I feel like parents should not, you know, actually I mean should not keep, you know, telling the same thing to their kids that okay, it's to your 21 so you should get married now, because they are still very young and they are still they are yet to explore what they want to do in their career, because that's also very important because you have only one life and only one chance to build your career and it's not like it's not like you can get married at any age, but I think if you learn when you're 21 or to up till 25, that's when is your learning age. So I would say that's my personal opinion actually. But I mean, nothing as mentioned, nothing is right or wrong. So it's up to them. And even if somebody gets married early, it's not necessary that you know they have. So only when they have kids, they will have a lot of responsibilities. I think other than that, I think they can still have a good career if the girl's husband is supportive, then they can still have a good career.
Yes, ma'am. So what is your idea of fun?
What is my idea of
fun? Having fun.
Okay. So when I travel, that's I have a lot of fun. So that's that's all I want to say.
Now, okay. Yes, ma'am. Okay, so we are at the end of our session. Thank you so much for ma'am. Thank you so much. It was really a great session. हजुरको इन्सपाइरिङ कुराहरूले हामी म लगायत यहाँनिर जति पनि मान्छेहरू हुनुहुन्छ जति पनि हाम्रो भ्युयर्सहरू हुनुहुन्छ सबैजना एकदमै नै धेरै इन्सपायर हुनुभयो होला भन्ने थट लिँदै चाहिँ म चाहिँ यो प्रोग्राम आज यहीँनिर नै एन्ड गर्न चाहन्छु. सो थ्याङ्क यू सो मच म्याम, थ्याङ्क यू सो मच भ्युयर्स हाम्रो आजको हर जर्नी सेसनमा आइदिनु भयो, क्वेसन्सहरू राखिदिनु भयो, हजुरहरूले इन्सपायर गरिदिनु भयो. थ्याङ्क यू सो मच.
थ्याङ्क यू
सो मच म्याम.